Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Thursday, August 9th. For those of you joining us now, we're coming to you live inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room, where the team has been monitoring the systems and the crew's activities aboard the International Space Station. This is the crew of Expedition 32. Leading the Orbit 2 team here in the Station Flight Control Room today is Flight Director Greg Whitney, seen standing here in this scene in the blue shirt, and next to him is Capcom Anna Fisher, who is relaying all ground messages up to the crew. Meanwhile, the six crew members aboard the station include a Russian cosmonaut and commander of the complex, Gennady Padalka, and flight engineers cosmonaut Sergei Revin and NASA astronaut Joe Acaba, shown here on the right-hand side. Padalka, Revin, and Acaba had launched to the orbiting complex aboard their Soyuz spacecraft as the Expedition 31 crew in May. Their vehicle docked to the Poisk module of the space station 2 days after their launch on May 14, and today they will complete their 88th consecutive day in space. Joining them there on the left-hand side is cosmonaut Yuri Malenchenko, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams, and Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide. Malenchenko, Williams, and Hoshide arrived at the International Space Station after docking their Soyuz spacecraft to the Rossviet module on July 16th. They're now in the middle of their fourth week in space. The space station with its crew aboard is flying at an altitude of about 250 statute miles. The orbiting facility is on a eastern track. It had just come across the southern tip of Brazil and is about to swing a northeastern track across the South Atlantic Ocean for an eventual pass over Africa. The Expedition 32 crew kicked off their day early this morning at 1 a.m. Central Time. They followed that by the first of their two daily planning conferences with ground controllers at mission control centers around the world to review today's activities. Today, aboard the orbiting complex, more robotics work takes center stage as flight engineers Joe Acaba and Aki Hoshide work together using the Japanese robotic arm, also known as the remote manipulator system, that is anchored at the Japanese experiment module, or Kibo, to unberth the multi-mission consolidated equipment from the exposed pallet and install it to the exposed facility unit number 8 of the Japanese experiment module's exposed facility. Just before today's update hour, Acaba and flight engineer Sunny Williams reviewed robotics procedures in advance of tomorrow's work to return that exposed pallet back into the Japanese HTV-3, the cargo vehicle. Then Williams and flight engineers Malenchenko and Hoshide will have a medical contingency drill a little after the hour. Williams also will spend some time with science. She'll work with the commercial generic bioprocessing apparatus. This is a small research facility that is used for biological experiments. Williams is working with the 6 YouTube Space Lab group activation pack experiments. She will also then work on the burning and suppression of solids experiment. This experiment examines the burning and extension of characteristics of a wide variety of fuel samples in the environment of microgravity. Acaba, Williams, and Hoshide will conduct visual testing prior to complete eye exams that are scheduled later next week. Acaba is currently working to clean filters of bacteria within nodes 1, 2, and 3, also known as the Unity, Harmony, and Tranquility. And earlier this morning, flight engineer Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide took some time out to talk with the Japanese Young Astronauts Club in Tokyo. And also today marks a special day for an honorary crew member aboard the space station, Smokey the Bear, who turns 68 today. Flight engineer Joe Acaba brought up a small plush Smokey Bear seen here in this picture. He had served as the zero-G indicator aboard the Soyuz spacecraft that carried him up to the International Space Station back in May. The space station serves as a platform for studying Earth, natural and man-made changes, including the devastation of forest fires or wildland fires. Smokey also serves as a way to raise awareness about fire prevention and fire safety. We'll be talking with Jeff Miller of the U.S. Forest Service about its partnership with NASA in a few minutes here in Mission Control Houston. And meanwhile, aboard the orbiting laboratory, each crew member will have completed their daily 2 hours of exercise to help mitigate the negative effects of long-duration spaceflight on their bodies and also maintain their physical health. They will do some prep work for the next day, participate in their second daily planning conference before the evening meals and pre-sleep period. The crew is then scheduled to go to sleep at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. This is Mission Control Houston.